Welcome all. Today's top breaking news with Gitanjali from Bayan Times. Former Andhra CM Chandrababu Naidu accuses YSRC of illegal phone tapping, urges PM to order inquiry. Alleging that the ruling YSR Congress in Andhra Pradesh was resorting to illegal tapping of phones to further its political gains, Telugu Desam Party President N. Chandrababu Naidu on Monday wrote to Prime Minister Narendra Modi requesting that the centre order an inquiry by a competent body to check the illegal acts. He alleged that the YSRC was illegally tapping phones of opposition parties, advocates, media persons and social activists. Locals in grip of fear as Godavari flows above danger mark, officials issue third warning. With the levels of Godavari River crossing the danger mark on Monday, falling unprecedented inflows from upstream, Irrigation Department officials at Sir Arthur Cotton Barrage at Dovalishwaram for the first time in recent years raised the third warning, which is given when the flood discharge crosses 17.75 lakh cusecs. One team of NDRF and two teams of SDRF were mobilized in East Godavari district, while two teams of SDRF have been mobilized in West Godavari district for rescue and relief operations. Andhra Pradesh reports 6,780 fresh COVID-19 cases, 82 deaths. 6,780 new COVID-19 cases, 7,866 recoveries and 82 deaths reported in Andhra Pradesh in the last 24 hours. The total number of cases stands at 2,96,609, including 84,777 active cases, 2,09,100 recovered cases and 2,732 deaths so far. India has recorded 26,47,663 confirmed COVID-19 cases, including 50,921 deaths. Maharashtra, Tamil Nadu, and Andhra Pradesh have reported the highest number of cases. Thirty-six patients in Hyderabad Mental Hospital test positive. Dogs allege lack of PPE kits. 36 patients admitted to the Iragada Mental Hospital here have tested positive for COVID-19. They were admitted to the closed wards of the hospital where 200 other patients are admitted. Hospital authorities are now conducting tests on all the 200 patients. The closed wards are those where patients who are destitute, abandoned by their families or sent by the district magistrate are given long-term treatment for various mental illnesses. The issue began about a fortnight ago when a PG doctor and senior resident tested positive for COVID-19. Eventually, last week, several nurses, class 4 staff and doctors got infected, triggering a check on other patients, said a doctor on condition of anonymity. Health Minister Yatala Rajinder visits rain-affected areas in Huzurabad. Health Minister Yatala Rajinder has on Monday toured the rain-affected areas in his Huzurabad constituency in a bid to estimate the extent of damage caused to crops, roads and bridges to bunds of water bodies. Rajinder visited several areas near Manakondur and Idulagattapalli tanks and Gangaram, Ilabaka, Challur and Valbapur of Vanavanka Mandal, Uppal, Kamalur, Shambunipalli, Vangapalli of Kamalapur Mandal, Naini tank in Jamikunta, Malayala Bridge and Iladukunta. CM KCR orders for evacuation of people living in low-lying areas. The Chief Minister is obtaining district-wise information and giving instructions and suggestions to officials to take up relief and rehabilitation measure. With incessant rains continuing to pound across the state and both Krishna and Godavari rivers in full speed, Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao on Monday directed the authorities to immediately evacuate people residing in low-lying areas, especially those along the rivers. He wanted them to take precautionary measures in Bhadrachalam town, which faces a threat from the ferocious Godavari River, and ensure the safety of locals. Telangana Assembly session from September 7 as per COVID-19 norms. The monsoon session of the State Legislative Assembly will be held from September 7. Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao held discussions with several ministers in this regard at Pragati Bhavan on Monday and decided to conduct the monsoon session to take decisions pertaining to some important issues. The Chief Minister observed that the assembly should be convened for at least 2 weeks and, after consulting with the ministers, decided to hold the monsoon session for 20 days to ensure a comprehensive discussion on important issues. With this, we conclude with our today's news headlines. For more such latest news and updates, like, share and subscribe Pine Times.